Even the world is trying to find a cure for the dreaded coronavirus pandemic. A report in Global Times said that a man from China, Yunnan province, died from Hantavirus while on bus to Shandong province. All the fellow passengers on the bus have been tested for the virus. And this provoked a new interest in Hantavirus, along with the concern of outbreak in the context of ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. The virus were first isolated in 1976 in Korea. Urban rats are to be the persistently infected with Hantavirus. Rats migrate on trading ships and disperse the virus whole world. Hantavirus infections has occurred in persons whose occupations place them in contact with rats. So why we are going to discuss on this topic, that is Hantavirus. Hantavirus has attracted more and more attention as emerging pathogenic virus in the past decades. It causes two distinct human diseases, hemorrhagic fever with renal syndrome, HFRS, and human pulmonary syndrome. So before going to details of these two disorders, first we are going to discuss about the source of this virus. So it is generally associated with rodents. What is the rodent? Rodents are a gaping mammals of an order that includes rats, mites, squirrels, hamsters, porcupines and their relatives, and are distinguished by strong constantly growing incisors and no canine teeth. Yes, so there are several distinct hantaviruses, each associated with specific rodent host. The infections in the rodents are lifelong without deleterious effects. Humans get affected by inhaling aerosols of rodent excreta like urine, feces and saliva. Note that person-to-person transmission is very rare. Now, what is the structure of this virus? So, Hantavirus comprises one of five genera of the virus family Bunyaviridae. They replicate in cytoplasm of the host cell and are composed of spherical lipid envelope. There are three single-stranded negative-sensed RNA segments designated as S, M and L. S for small, M for medium and L for large. And these are encoding for the nucleocapsid protein. Yes, this is the surface envelope and this is made up of glycoproteins G1 and G2. Now we are moving our point of interest, that is clinical features. So what's happened in this disease is there are two significant clinical features, that is hemorrhagic fever with renal syndrome and human pulmonary syndrome, right? So in hemorrhagic fever with renal syndrome, hem means blood. So hemorrhagic means there is a bleeding disorder, right? So in this disease, there might be high grade fever, abdominal pain and bleeding. There might be petechy due to the bleeding, or there can be intravascular coagulation. In GI manifestation, there might be nausea, vomiting and diarrhea. Now, in human pulmonary syndrome, so there is a word pulmonary and it refers to the lung. So, there can be high-grade fever, myalgia, headache, this can be occur. Or, if we specify the respiratory symptoms, there can be elevated heart rate, rapid breathing, or due to the insufficiency of oxygen, there can be hypoxia, right? So these are the clinical features of this disease. So what is the treatment of this disease? So as of now, there is no vaccine for this disease. So there is no specific treatment or cure for this disease, right? So there is no specific treatment or cure for this disease. So the only option is left, that is intensive care. So in intensive care, we can give the adequate O2 supply for maintenance. We can support the hemodynamic functioning. And the drug like ribavirin, which is antiviral drug, which is shows some efficacy against this disease. So this is about the treatment. Now, the most important part is end-to-end prevention, because we don't have the cure, right? So how can we control this disease? Yes, we can control it by rodent control, because rodents are the original source for this disease, right? For prevention, care must be taken to avoid inhaling aerosolites, dried, etc. when cleaning rodent infected structures. So this is all about this Hantavirus. So don't panic about this disease.
Hantavirus is one illness you don't need to worry about right now. Thanks for watching this video.